came out. Bharatnatyam, as we all know, is a classical dance form of South India. But for our next presenter, it is a sacred art which is intense, demanding, challenging, intoxicating, and yet most often his solace, faith, and strength. He challenged criticism from the classical dance community when he took to Bharatnatyam at the age of 16. But now he wins accolades for his fancy footwork. While practitioners of this art form are known to attach some gravity to it, he chooses to call it his lover. He describes himself as a dancer whose abhinya and nrita is colored by the cheeky character of Bangalore. Please welcome on stage Charles Ma.
Oh, thanks so much. Like in dance class, my teachers would always say, talk less, dance more. So I'll begin with dancing, right?
Tajanu tadin, 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 t
Bharatnatyam with a runny nose is not a very pretty picture. But, you know, I think it's very exciting because it's been a whole week of talking to young people. I don't mean to be condescending to anybody, but spoke to a lot of young kids at PESIT, at Parikrama. I heard SIBM challenging the convention. I said, wow, I just have to be here. You know, because for people who don't know about my journey, actually, I'm not here because I challenged the convention. I think a woman challenged me, and I lived up to the challenge. Now, you know, we can't do without women. This one woman was this beautiful classical dancer, extremely arrogant. And they're very beautiful. They have a right to be arrogant. Most South Indian dancers are. My teachers are beautiful. Like I coined up a little phrase. I said, lethally beautiful South Indian women, okay? So, yeah, they deserve to be. They can't afford to be arrogant. I think I'll tell you where it began. So, as every young Bangalore boy, I was cycling, playing football, dirtying my shirt, and for to beat my friends, say, "Ma, look how dirty my shirt is." My mother would go crazy. And I used to dance a lot. You know, Bangalore was becoming the pub city that time in 1999. And you know, pubs, and we were dancing, and somebody spotted me and said, "You know, this boy dances well. Pull him onto a group production." So I went in the group production. I was doing Bollywood, and they said, "Wow, this boy is so good at Bollywood. Come on, rock on." In that, there was this classical dancer. She walked in, everybody would be like, you know, like that. So I was like, then I saw them do this flower, and this is the bee that goes into the flower. So they used it in a contemporary, in a very metaphorical way. I said, wow, can I also do that? Typical of a classical dancer, she says, "This is not for juniors. This is not for you." And then it started. I said, nobody does that to me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to learn classical dance. I'm going to be as good as you. and I'm going to teach you a lesson one day. That's when the challenge began. Yeah, you know, and but then I was a smart kid. So I said, she's learning Kathak. She's 3 years ahead of me. If I learn Kathak, I'll never catch up with her. So what do I do? I'll go around. I'll do Bharatnatyam. Yes, yes, good idea. So, you know, that's how Bharatnatyam started, you know, actually. Because I had a huge, I think, when you're young, that young, and you come from a boys' school, you're very arrogant, okay, about hot, you're hot-blooded. So I didn't know what, I didn't know Bharatnatyam was not for boys. I didn't know, you know, it was a Brahmin-dominated art form, blah, blah. I packed my bags and said, come on, I want to learn this art form. I started learning it. And a lot of, but I think because you, I initially did it because it was a challenge. I said, no, I have to beat this girl. I'm going to get very good at Bharatnatyam and I'm going to beat her at it. On the way, you know, I think it's fate. I started loving this thing immensely. And only yesterday when I was sitting and thinking, I said, it's been such a long journey, 10, 11 years. I don't remember a single, I mean, there were hard times, sweating and this and that. I don't remember it. Because you know why? It's a very profound, like, eureka moment. Because I love it so much. It was never hard work, you know. I started loving Bharatnatyam. But along the journey, you know, then you come to reality. You know, you flop down to reality. So my friends tell me, hey, what are you learning this for, man? It's for girls, man. Or they would say, you know, dancers have big, big eyes. Look at your eyes, small, small eyes. You can't do Bharatnatyam. You'll be a failure, they said. Total failure. So on that journey, you know, there was soul searching. I said, okay, I'll do Odissi because, you know, it's closer to home. I'm partly Assamese, partly Nepalese, and my granddad is Chinese. And also, I said, small eyes. All those Odissi boys do. Okay, I'll also join the party. So I did that, Odissi, a little while drifting here and there. But you can't cheat yourself. So somewhere down the lane, I said, Odissi is not sitting well with me. The movements are too rounded. My hands are very, you know, straight and, you know, they dart out quickly. I speak Tamil. I didn't know a word of what I was doing in Odissi. I didn't know because it's all Odia. So I didn't know a word. But then I said, no more cheating. I'm going to do this. Who cares? I'm going to dance. Because I believed that I was going to be damn good one day. I believed. So I did it. And then there came a time when I was dancing continuously and in college, they said, hey man, there are no dancers in college. You have to go to IIT Sarang and go compete. You lose, it's okay, just go. So I was excited. I said, now's my chance to go and go to the homeland of Bharatnatyam and go and take part. Packed my bags, went to Chennai. First time out of the state alone, with a duffel bag and all that. Reached Chennai, 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm lost in some bus station. Scary. I opened the tap, muddy water. I had bath under a tap. I still remember my first performance, under a tap with muddy water. The toilet is flushing me instead of flushing itself. Terribly, terrible experience in Chennai, my first day in Chennai. Put my makeup on, did all that stuff, and I went in. Walked into the OAT, the fright of my life. I see these, I check the list, 50 dancers, okay? Padma Bhushan students, and teachers, daughters. And they're all so beautiful, you know, with flowers and temple jewelry. And so I'm so scared, I walk in, and the first look, you know, the first times are always things you'll never forget. I walked in, and the first beautiful girl, I don't know, I still remember her look. She did this to me. I mean, in Chennai, now, girl, I get ready myself, my teachers do, but spoiled kids as they are, their mothers will come along, their aunties will come along, and they'll tie their plaids, they'll put their, you know, belt on. So always dancer, mother, auntie, or somebody. So this girl next to her mother, she looks at me like this. Oh, I was so, it was like, ouch, it hit me so bad. I said, come with me, I'm going to beat you. I said, I lose my life, I'm going to win this performance. Come on. So 50 dancers, I sat like a mouse there in the corner, and all these beautiful girls are dancing and dancing and dancing and dancing. They said, Ayo Pavam, poor fellow in Tamil, Ayo Pavam. Looks like he's already lost. Throw him on stage, get over with it. I was 48 or something. They said, go 7-8. Threw me on stage, and I think hard work, and I really worked hard because I'm very competitive. For me, Bharatnatyam was never anything spiritual or never anything, you know, beyond that. It was very competitive. I said, like a sport, how my football was, how my cycling, karate was. I said, come on, Bharatnatyam now. You know, and I'll tell you the other, you know, sure, I don't too much time to talk, but it's a very funny story. My mother thought I can't tell my mother, Ma, you know what, I have a new hobby, I'm learning Bharatnatyam. She was scandalized. So she heard noise in the terrace. I mean, middle class family, you know, we live in a rented house and top there was a space above my house. What to do? Went to practice before college. Finished practicing, run to college, come back before the sun goes down, because that place was haunted, I believe. So before the sun went down, practice and come back home. So in the morning, my mother would hear that, that, because of your tay, you keep doing the rhythm pattern. What is it? Ma, karate ma. Oh, okay, practice. Poor thing, yeah, she's my biggest supporter now. Through that, and then I won that competition, you know, 50 dancers, girls, yeah. I won that competition. Yeah. So, after winning that competition, I was so excited. The judge was a Padma Bhushan student. I said, akka, akka, in my bad Tamil. I said, akka, akka, how did I win? She said, you know what? Beyond technique, beyond all that you learn, there's something is called passion that you have. And that was the eureka moment. I said, no matter what happens, now I made it. I beat those 50 beautiful girls. I'm a dancer. So I'm going to be a dancer. I never gave up, you know. But I think on the journey, check, yeah, the mic doesn't like me. And my voice is like this because I teach a lot, screaming at these kids. Say it. Aramandi, okar. Aramandi is this, okay? And it's terrible. Before I started learning classical dance, I would look at other dancers and say, hey, what is that potty position or something like that. I would always say, what are they doing? Yeah, this Bharatnatyam is so boring. He's jumping about. That girl, that boy looks so girlish. He dances, he talks like a girl. So, you know, and the maids in my house would tell my mother, when they found the Tamilian maids, Amma, Amma, don't let him learn dance. He'll become like one girl, ma. My mother would burst out crying. She said, what my neighbors think, what you're doing, and what will we do? Will we, people will laugh at you, they laugh at me. Forget it. I was dancing anyway. And yeah. It's been a tough journey, but you know, I'm telling honestly, I don't remember the hard things. And every day as I dance more and more, there's a point in a dancer's life where it goes beyond technicality, it goes beyond a bad leg, it goes beyond all that, where the mind and the body just merges. And dancing becomes such a joy. I honestly haven't practiced. I've had a bad injury, but I said, I have to dance for you guys. Damn it, I'm going to dance anyway. Bad, technical, not technical, dance. So I said, yeah, so I was like, okay, just dance. And that's the point, you know, when your mind and your heart meets, it's a beautiful experience. So I'd love sharing that experience of Bharatnatyam with you guys. You know, everyone says, oh God, you're so cool. You know, challenge the conventional and all that. I never looked at it like that, you know, because I only look like this. Forget my roots. My granddad's Chinese, my grandma. We were born and brought up like South Indians. So sometimes I forget I look like this and I do Bharatnatyam, you know, because I completely think I'm so South Indian. In fact, when that little problem between the Muslim community and the Northeast community happened, I'm busy walking out and all. Somebody said, go inside your house. The world's going to get hammered. I forgot that I'm so Northeast looking. I thought I'm also a boy. My neighbors are all hanging out together and doing our things. I completely forgot, you know. I was like, they said, what are you doing out? You're not scared, huh? They'll hammer you. I said, shit, man, I look like this. I go in. So I was under house arrest for 2-3 days. But I never thought of it as challenging the unconventional. But in the journey of being an artist, a good artist, something very beautiful happens, is that it opens your mind to a lot of things. It opened my mind to racism. It opened my mind to who I am as a person. What is my position in society, my world? I understand people better. Yeah, it's made me a little more humble person. Initially, when you're young, you're very arrogant about your dancing, and all classical dancers have this aura, and my teachers are stars. But I think as you grow, it allows you to appreciate the smaller things in life. And I think through challenging the conventional, actually, I've begun to appreciate the conventional, actually, you know. I think that's important thing about other people's lives. Somebody said, oh God, you're so cool. I'm doing engineering, I'm fed up. I'm doing this, I'm fed up. I'm doing that, I'm fed up. I said, but some people love what they do. Some people love engineering. Some people love doing medical. So I think through challenging the conventional, I've learned to appreciate the conventional, small things of people. The small things, like yesterday, a judge to a competition at Samsung. The office boys do their job with such joy. I enjoy my job thoroughly. I love Bharatnatyam. And to see an office boy, you know, so ready to give his life up for that silly office job of his, amazing, touching. So I think that's the essence of life, of who we are as people, is no matter how small a job your job is, but you love your job, that's what matters. I see a lot of people, like I went for the Ink Conference 2012, 11, both. People, youngsters around me were so brilliant. They were doing things who were They're doing things that made a difference to people's lives, and I was here being a dancer. It's a very selfish pursuit, isn't it? I'm wearing very beautiful silk, I'm wearing gold, I'm dancing myself, the audience applauds. It's a very selfish pursuit. So I felt this small, you know, when there are other youngsters like me who are making difference in people's lives. And then I realized that a society, I mean, I sat through an entire session of only talks. I was like, I just had to walk out. And then I realized that art and music are a very important gauge of a society's of health. Where there are people who appreciate art and music, it's a healthy society and community. And I think as Indians, we all love Bollywood. Forget you loving classical dance. We're a healthy community, and touch wood, and let's go there. So I'll close with, again, a very unconventional piece. I never realized it was unconventional again. I just learned it and said, oh God, cool. But this is a very unconventional piece. In Bharatnatyam, a jati is a mridangam syllable, ta, dit, tom, nam. And the rhythmic patterns could go into janna, janna, kirra, kitta. It could be ta, tarita, jam, and they close like that. But my teacher, Priyadarshini Govind, Srimati Priyadarshini Govind, one of India's leading soloists today, has taken the Shiva Panchakshari mantra, Om Namah Shivaya, and made it into a jati in a rhythmic pattern, which is never done. It receives people criticize it and people appreciate it. But I think, again, that's challenging the conventional, and you take a risk, and I think that's what helps us grow as people. It helped me as an artist to try something that's not done before. And the choreography is by Srimati Priyadarshini Govind. It's the Om Namah Shivaya Jati, followed by a small Shiva Shloka.
Shivaya, 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 Namah, Om, Om, Namah, Shivaya. त्र्यम्बकाय त्रिपुरान्तकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकण्ठाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदाशिवाय श्रीमन्महादेव